r/Askreddit, medical workers of Reddit, what were the most haunting last words you've heard from a patient? Sweet guy in his 20s with endocarditis, heart valve infection, caused by 4th drug abuse. I was prepping him for his 3rd open heart surgery when he sat up, looked me in the eye, and said, "I'm going to die, aren't I?" He did not survive the surgery. My husband is a PICU nurse, and one morning he came home in a bit of a daze. I asked him what was wrong, and he told me about a little boy who had been in PICU for a few days already and wasn't getting better. Most nights, the little boy would wake up so one of the nurses would keep him company while he fell asleep again. My husband was doing just that. He read him a book then just sat there with the boy listening to music, so he would go back to sleep. Before falling asleep, the little boy said, "You were my favorite." The boy passed away in the morning. His little heart gave out and refused to restart. Although all patients are important, some leave more of an impression than others. Until that point, that little boy hadn't stood out to my husband, and he felt terrible about it because, clearly, he had made a big impression on that little boy. That was the only patient's funeral he has ever attended. Not a medic. My friend's brother committed suicide. He hung himself in his closet while she watched TV in the living room. The last thing he said before going upstairs was, "I'm going to rest." That weirded her out because he never spoke like that. Hospice nurse here had a patient who was experiencing terminal agitation. With an expression of complete terror on his face, he said, "Help me. They are coming to get me." It wasn't words, but the most haunting death was a patient who was DNR through her and her family's wishes. She was losing her battle, and her family wasn't there. She was getting frantic, and looking around, and half sitting up in bed, and a nurse with more experience than me took her hand and calmly said, "It's okay. You're not alone. We are right here with you. It's okay to leave." The patient immediately calmed, put her head back on the pillow and died. I knew I wanted to be that nurse when I grew up. How the hell did she know just what to do and say? I've never forgotten it. When I was a senior resident, a young man, late 20s, was admitted for pneumonia. He got worse quickly, and I was called to his room to help while on call that night. He was having trouble breathing and needed intubated. I explained all this to him, and that I would sedate him and then get him intubated, so we could help him breathe. He agreed and we got everything ready. The last thing he said to me was, "Doc, please don't let me die." I told him I would do my very best. I got him intubated and transferred to the ICU. A few weeks later I was on call covering the ICU and he was barely hanging on. I knew he would not make it through the night. He went into V-fib several times and I was able to bring him back, but only briefly. He was just too sick and he died shortly after that. It was horrible talking to his mother and girlfriend and comforting them knowing the last words he ever spoke were to me saying, "Please don't let me die." RN here. I don't remember this guy's admitting diagnosis. He wasn't assigned to me, but my coworker asked me to help start and forth on him. He needed a unit of blood and his peripheral access had gone bad. I placed a tourniquet and was ready to stick. Then he looked at me and said, "I'm dying." Immediately went unresponsive. I checked his pupils. I watched one dilate and the other constrict. We coded him, never got him back. Not haunting, but it went, "So this is what retirement is like." He got hit by a car within a few days of retirement, and it has to be the funniest last words. Normally they are sad last words. Nursing home. Most elderly people are at ease as they get nearer and nearer to death. But this old lady, as she deteriorated over her last week or so, would scream, "I don't want to die. I don't want to die." Really heartbreaking to see. I was visiting my grandpa and had to leave town and go back to medical school, and I told him I loved him and would see him later. He told me he loved me too, but no, I won't. He was right. He died a week later of pneumonia. I'm an emergency nurse, and there's one thing that always gets me when patients die. Not what they say, but what their husband/wife/parents say when they've gone. I've had it a few times. But the most memorable was a man in his 70s whose wife had just passed away, and he was holding her hand and crying, and he just looked up at me and said, "I've loved her for 55 years. She's my whole life. What do I do without her? It breaks me every time." Nurse, in hospital caring for 40-ish man with brain tumor, coming in and out of consciousness, not to be resuscitated. His 16-year-old daughter was crying non-stop for 12 hours. His wife, who had been given a few months to prepare herself, was calm and focused on her husband. I had to routinely check his level of consciousness, which involved talking to him in a loud voice, response to auditory stimulation, which I did not like to do. So I asked his wife to do the loud voice part, so the voice he would hear would be hers, not mine. And she did so without hesitation. The only response we observed with her vocalization was that this by now profoundly unconscious patient took her hand to his lips and kissed it. He stopped breathing very soon after that. I'm haunted, but not in a bad way. A teenage girl who was having an asthma attack while she was at someone's house she wasn't supposed to be at. My mom's gonna kill me. She died at the hospital. Damn, now I'm going to be better about taking my inhaler with me to places. Not the very last words, but I had a patient in her early 20s who was severely thrombocytopenic and bleeding profusely for days ask me if she was going to make it. I had to look her in the eyes and tell her there is a good chance she wouldn't. I thought she would bust into tears, but no, she just kind of sat back and accepted it. I think she already knew. She died shortly after I got off shift. I'm an intern at a home for patients with Alzheimer's and have only been there for a few weeks. The first patient to pass during my internship said back quote, "Who am I?" For some reason it saddens me deeply, and I can't seem to let it go. With wide eyes, don't listen to my family, they want to keep me around forever, but I just want to die. They won't let me. I'm an EMT. Had a patient say I don't feel so good, right before they dropped dead of massive heart attack. It was just the matter of fact way they said it. My goddamn twat is cold. Tough 86-year-old bird with orange hair slash white roots and tattoos. Last words spoken while having groin prepped with cold soap for cardiac catheterization. Not a medical worker, but when I was 14 my friends and I were joking around before our 7th period theater class. My one friend, who was always a big goof, was playing along with a joke that he and another classmate were breaking up and said, "This relationship is over." Then spun around and fell to the floor for dramatic effect. Except it wasn't for dramatic effect, because he actually suffered heart failure and died instantly from an unknown condition, acute myocarditis. None of us realized it and laughed along. I even picked up his glasses from the floor and put them on to tease him about how blind he was. When I tried to give him his glasses back, I was struck by how discolored his face was, and then blood began to pour from his mouth. That's when the screaming started. Absolutely screwed me as a 14-year-old to realize we could all just drop dead at any moment. Can I smoke in here? We were on an ambulance. Like the video if you enjoyed. Subscribe to Reddit for more stories.